Hi everybody and welcome. Now some of you may already be aware of the cloud twin towers that are to go up in South Korea in the Yongsan business district of Seoul, South Korea. Yongsan means Dragon Hill. So there are the towers there and they have an obvious likeness to the twin towers of September the 11th, 2001 in New York. Here's another picture and we can see the cloud towers here. And of course this part here would be the clouds. And this is perhaps heaven up here on top of the clouds. The Bible is very clear on the location of the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is within you. That's according to the Bible. There are references to heaven and the clouds in the Bible also. I'm just using that as a reference. There are other references, but this is perhaps heaven up here. But of course, you can have clouds in your head and all the rest of it with the allegory of the Bible. But we'll move on. And here's another night shot. Again, it looks quite ominous in a way. I don't know that this is tasteful at all. And here's yet another shot at night, and it's part of this larger area here, which is the Yongsan, the Dragon Hill business district. Yet another shot, an artist's depiction of what it's going to be like up on the clouds, up in heaven perhaps. And here is yet another shot up there in the clouds. So I'll just read this part here. The project is part of a master plan for the area by New York architect studio Libeskind and is due to complete in 2015. So studio Libeskind are putting together the master plan for this area in South Korea, in Yongsan. Now Libeskind is also responsible for the Ground Zero area in New York. And this is Daniel Libeskind here, the head of the, an architect and head of the company. So, and he is also responsible for the 1776 foot tall Freedom Tower there in New York. So we can also see here From the Ashes, which is perhaps a reference to the Phoenix also. So it's all very interesting and ties together, folks. Now, also within that business district, Dragon Hill, if you will, we have these two towers here. So we'll just have a closer look at these two towers. Now, they are designed by a Chicago firm, Adrian Smith and Gordon Hill Architecture. Okay, and as you can see here, they're going up in Yongsan in the business district in Seoul. So here's another shot. Here's another shot here. You can see the scale-like glass panels on the side there. And again, you can see what is perhaps the serpent sort of snaking up the towers, if you will, the two serpents. So I'll just do a bit of reading out of here about it, and you might pick up a few things. So we know that it's designed by Adrian Smith and Gordon Hill Architecture, and to announce the Dancing Dragons. I'll just go down here. The mini towers feature a dramatic series of diagonal massing cuts that create a living space that float beyond the structure. This recalls the eaves of traditional Korean temples, a design theme echoed both in the geometry of the building skin and the jutting canopies at the tower's base. The themes extend in the building skin, which suggests the scales of Korean mythical dragons, which seem to dance around the core, hence the project's name, Yongsan. So Yongsan, the name of the overall development, which means Dragon Hill in Korean. Now, the dancing dragon's scale-like skin is also a performative element. Gaps between its overlapping panels feature operable 600 millimeter vents through which air can circulate, making the skin breathable like that of certain animals. And there are some interesting numbers in here, so I'll just read this through as well. Towers 1 and 2, about 450 meters and 390 meters tall respectively, share an architectural language and therefore a close family resemblance, but are not identical. In the taller structure, the 88-level Tower 1, the massing cuts at the top and bottom of the towers are V-shaped, and the 77-level Tower 2, the cuts move diagonally in a single unbroken line. They are also arranged in a radial pattern and the core that is perceptible as the viewers move around the tower. Okay, so we'll just move on from there. Now, today I was reminded of September 11th when I looked at one of the local news sites here in Australia on the web. So we have the death of Donna Summers here. And I think it was in her opinion, she has put this down to what is perhaps the breathing in of particles, inhaling of particles during the 9/11 attacks. So I was reminded of the September 11 attacks today. I'd just like to make some commentary about some stuff that's happening within the sort of 9/11 movement, which is perhaps unfortunate. So here is Dr. Judy Wood. She's in a studio there. She wrote a book about 9/11 and produced video and all the rest of it. Here we have the architects and engineers also. That's just from their website, a bit of a capture. And here is a shot of them both. Now, within the 9/11 movement, there are people who are saying they're sort of writing off the architects and engineers because they won't take on Judy Wood's information and all the rest of it. And I'd just like to comment that I just find it really unfortunate. From what I can see, that the material of Dr. Judy Wood's her material doesn't really fit the ethic of what architects and engineers are trying to do. And there are so many people out there trying to write off the architects and engineers because they won't take the case to court or they haven't taken the case to court. But as they say, as Richard Gage says, you know, they are not attorneys. I was looking at some stuff there from 2010 and they were attempting to raise some money for attorneys, but you know, really this is up to a legal team to take this on. And they were criticised of not taking their information to court because Judy Wood had gone and done that with her material. But Judy Wood, her case, the Qui Tam case, completely failed. And I don't know why people would push for the engineers and architects to follow the same model and go for failure, basically. It's not the responsibility of the architects and engineers, in my opinion, to take on a case. They have put together the information, and anyone out there can get organize a team of lawyers, attorneys, and so forth to put together a case and use their information. That is what it's there for. So anyway, I just think it's stupid and perhaps pathetic, actually, that people are kind of writing off the architects and engineers because they don't sort of take on the information of Dr. Judy Woods and so forth. But you know, both of these parties have something to offer. But from the academic standpoint, Dr. Judy Woods's material is really off the charts, so to speak, and she's talking about exotic weapons and all the rest of it. So anyway, there is a bit of a disconnect here, whereas the architects and engineers feel that they are dealing with material that is relevant to the sort of standard academic sort of format, if you will. It's very basic stuff. I don't know why people out there in the 9/11 movement these days can't understand that. It's really unfortunate. But anyway, both of these entities or groups or Judy Woods, etc., both have something to offer. Anyway, I hope you found this video interesting, and I'll see you later.